We want to solve the given quadratic equations by factoring. Notice all the equations are in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0 when a is equal to 1, meaning the first term is x squared. So looking at our first example, remember the first step in factoring is to look for a greatest common factor. The only common factor these terms share is 1, so if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomials, where the first terms come from the factors of x squared, which should be x and x, and then the second terms of the binomial factors would come from the factors of positive 8 that add to positive 6, or the factors of c that add to b. And since 2 times 4 is equal to 8, and 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, 2 and 4 are the winning factors. And since the 2 and 4 are both positive, we would have x plus 2 times x plus 4. Now that we have the trinomial factored, we can use the zero product property to solve this equation. If this product is equal to 0, then x plus 2 must equal 0, or the factor x plus 4 must equal 0. And now we solve these two equations for x. So we'll subtract 2 on both sides here. We have x equals negative 2, or subtract 4 on both sides here, we have x equals negative 4. These would be our two solutions to the quadratic equation. And then looking at the second example, again, the only common factor between these three terms is 1. So if this is going to factor, it'll factor into two binomials. The first terms come from the factors of x squared, that would be x and x. And the second terms will be the factors of negative 50 that add to positive 23. And since negative 2 times positive 25 is equal to negative 50, and negative 2 plus 25 does equal positive 23, the two factors we need are negative 2 and positive 25. So one factor will be x minus 2, the other factor will be x plus 25. And now to solve, since this product is equal to 0, either x minus 2 must equal 0 or x plus 25 must equal 0. So here we'll add 2 to both sides. So if x equals 2 or subtract 25 on both sides, we have x equals negative 25. Next example. The only common factor is 1, so again, if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomials. The first term of each factor will come from the factors of x squared, that's x and x. The second terms will come from the factors of positive 15 that add to negative 8. And since the sum of the factors must be negative, but the product must be positive, we'll have to use two negative factors of 15. For example, negative 3 times negative 5 is equal to positive 15, but negative 3 plus negative 5 does give us negative 8, the coefficient of the middle term. So our two factors will be x minus 3 and x minus 5. And now to solve this equation, since its product is equal to 0, either x minus 3 must equal 0 or x minus 5 must equal 0. So here we'll add 3 to both sides of the equation. We have x equals 3, or add 5 to both sides, and we have x equals positive 5. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more example. There are no common factors, so this will factor into two binomials. First terms will come from the factors of x squared, so we have x and x. And now we want the factors of negative 24 that add to negative 5. Well, let's see, negative 3 times 8 would be negative 24, but the sum would be positive 5. We want a negative 5, so if we use a negative 8 and a positive 3, this would give us negative 24, and the sum would be negative 5. So these are the two winning factors. So we have x minus 8 times x plus 3. Therefore, the solutions occur when x minus 8 equals 0 or x plus 3 equals 0. Add 8 to both sides. Here we have x equals 8. Subtract 3 on both sides, and here we have x equals negative 3. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.